Yes, thank you, madam. We are ready from our side. A few more will join shortly in next 5 minutes, and mostly we have joined now. So you can start, madam. Thank you.
Okay.
And we are very eager to listen from your side. So you can start, madam.
Okay. I'll take 1 or 2 minutes to present some background information, which I think can be easily missed by Jeevika staff. But, so thank you to all of you for joining this presentation, and particularly to Jeevika for facilitating our survey. Let me begin by briefly going through the background of the program. Jeevika had started work in 2006 through a pilot program, and its success led to the program being scaled up to 38 districts. Evaluation studies showed that the Jeevika program was successful in generating income and reducing poverty, but it was expected that there would be a spillover to the health sector. This did not come out. Health outcomes, particularly nutritional outcomes, remained low in the pilot districts. So as a result of this, Jeevika decided to introduce a program specifically targeting health outcomes, in particular the nutritional outcomes of mothers and children. So in 2012, a health and nutrition strategy was introduced in 6 districts. In 2016, the strategy was scaled up. It was a result of the positive results, which was documented in different studies by World Bank, IFPRI, and so on. And in today's study, we are going to look at the health and nutrition strategy. The specific question that we are going to examine is, are Jeevika members more likely to comply with dietary norms compared to non-members? So we are going to look at the children 0 to 5 months and children 6 to 35 months. And in case of mothers, we are going to look at minimum dietary diversity and dietary scores. Now, how do we define dietary scores and minimum dietary diversity? So we have divided the main food items into 8 groups.
Just a minute.
Yes.
May I request all the members who have joined to mute their microphone, please. May I request Mr. Anand Kumar to mute your microphone, please.
On key now.
And by the way, if you have any questions, please feel free to interrupt and ask questions. So we divided the food items into 8 major groups, which you can see in this slide. And if a person consumed at least 4 or more items, we said that that person is complying with minimum dietary diversity. In case of mothers, we also estimated how many food groups they are consuming. This is called the dietary score. So in case of the child, we had 2 outcomes. For the 0 to 5 months, it was whether they were breastfed exclusively. In case of 6 to 35 months child, it was whether they consumed at least 4 food groups. So both these outcome variables are binary. In case of the mother, the outcome variables are 2, dietary score, how many food groups consumed, this is continuous, and a binary variable, which is the minimum dietary diversity. Now let's come to the sampling design. So we employed a multi-stage sampling design. We selected 6 districts out of 38. So in the first stage, we selected 13 districts where the HMS program and the GVCA technical support programs had been in operation for 5 years or more than 5 years. We created an index given in the last column, which is based on female literacy, percentage of forward caste population, and the non-agricultural workforce. Obviously, we are considering only the male workers. So based on this index, we ranked all the districts and divided them into 3 classes. From each class, we took 2 districts randomly. After we selected a district, we again divided the blocks into 2 parts. In the first group, we had the blocks where the HNS program had been introduced, and in the other, we had 2 blocks. We selected 2 blocks of the remaining. So these were again selected using random sampling. In each block, using the PPS, probability proportion to size method, we selected 5 villages. Within a village, we selected 20 respondents, of which 10 were GVCA members and 10 were non-members. So this is the survey districts. You can see that they are more or less spread across Bihar. The sample size is 6 districts, 4 blocks, 5 villages, and 20 respondents. So a total of 2,400 women. The recruitment criteria was the respondent had to be a permanent resident of the village and she had to have a child below 36 months. The questionnaire was P-tested in Vaishali district and the main survey was started in January. In March, unfortunately, the lockdown started and we had to stop the survey. So we found that we had reached 94% of the target. We had covered 2250 respondents. And so we decided to stop the survey completely. So our results are based on 2,250. And as you can see, that the number of GVCA and non-GVCA members are almost same. Check whether so let us look at the sample profile. We can see that most of the respondents are in the 25 to 30 age group. Non-members are slightly younger. You can see this 17.08 compared to 4, then this is 4 versus 14. If you look at the household size, the majority, the average household size is 5 to 7. In case of the educational attainment, there's a sharp difference between GVCA and non-GVCA members. So you can see, in case of the GVCA, about 63% have less than 5 years of education. This proportion is 46 for non-GVCA members. On the other hand, the proportion who have more than 6 years of education is comparatively higher for non-members. You can see 27, 38, 11% difference. In case of more than 10 years of education, it's about 5 to 6% difference. In case of occupational profile, however, there's not much difference. This is the occupation of the respondent's husband. Agriculture, labor, non-agricultural wage labor, petty self-employed, and region salaried labor, these comprise the majority. As it is not much to see, we collected information on the stock of draft animals, different consumer commodities, and so on, the housing quality, and so on. We combined information on caste and religion to create a variable, socio-religious identity. And you can see that the majority are, more than 50% are OBCs. Forward caste comprise about a one-third of the sample. Our method, we employed a mixed method. The survey data was analyzed using both bivariate and multivariate methods. We also had some focus group discussions and network mapping. So now let's come to the main part, the findings. Let's start off with the outcomes for children. And as you remember, we have two outcomes, breastfeeding and MDD, or minimum dietary diversity. If you look at breastfeeding, you can say the percentage is very high, about 80%. And there's not much difference between Jivika and non-Jivika members. But if you look at the gender breakup, two findings are important. One is the boy child has a higher probability of being breastfed exclusively. So this fits in with earlier studies on gender discrimination in the early stages of a person's life. The second finding is that if you compare between the blue and red line, blue is non-Jivika, red is Jivika. You can see that in case of the girl child, Jivika members are slightly ahead, 2%. But in case of the boys, we see a reversal. That is, Jivika members, if the mother is a Jivika, the boy is less likely to be breastfed. Coming to the minimum dietary diversity, we can see that the proportions are much lower, slightly above 50%. And here we find that there's a difference between Jivika members and non-Jivika members. And this difference is apparent even if you look at it, the data gender-wise. In case of both boys and girls, Jivika members, mothers, are more likely to ensure that the children comply with minimum dietary diversity. Now, let us look at the consumption of specific food groups. Well, the first obvious thing is that non-vegetarian items is very low. It's almost zero. The problem, of course, is that every state or region has a particular diet which is defined by its culture and tradition. And earlier studies of the HNS has also remarked on this. It's going to be very difficult for Jivika to try to overcome this problem, increasing the consumption of non-vegetarian items. And Jivika may have been in operation for about 10 years, but one should remember that these practices are in vogue for centuries. So it's going to take a very long time before it's possible to increase the consumption of non-vegetarian items. But where Jivika can act is the consumption of yellow and orange fruits, dark green vegetables, and other fruits and vegetables. This is also very low among children. You can see it's 7, 8, 9, it's ranging from about 6 to 10. So this is somewhere where there are no cultural taboos, and Jivika should try to increase the consumption of these items. Now let's look at these items by different socioeconomic correlates. Let's focus first on exclusive breastfeeding. So we look at three correlates: education, social religious groups, and asset. In the first graph, we have shown how the proportion of children who are breastfed varies across the educational levels of the mother. And the first thing is that normally we would expect that more educated mothers are more aware and they are more likely to adhere to dietary norms. But in this case, we see that the percentage of children who are breastfed is lowest for the most educated mothers. And this holds for both Jivika and non-Jivika mothers. If you look at the variation across social religious groups, again we will find that in case of SCSTs, the proportion is slightly less, the red bar, but for the Jivika members, there's not much difference between OBC, forward caste, and Muslims. Among the non-members, exclusive breastfeeding is more common among the Muslim community. If you look at the variation across asset holdings, again we find a negative relation. Those who are affluent have a lower incidence of exclusive breastfeeding. This is somewhat strange.
Here, I'd like to add one point. So while we went for the survey, we found that more educated and affluent mothers looked down on breastfeeding. They came to substitute under many circumstances by milk powder or diluted buffalo milk. Actually, they are thinking that as if this milk powder or dilated milk, these are perfect substitutes and they are practicing accordingly. So, you know, the Jivika members can work at this point. While we will discuss the policy matters, our suggestions for the Jivika members will be, you know, they may work, you know, in this particular issue. Yes, that can be.
Now, coming to the minimum dietary diversity, if you look at the variation across education, this time we are getting a slightly positive trend. As the mother becomes more educated, she's more likely to ensure that the minimum dietary diversity is complied with. In case of non-Jivika, however, we find that there's a problem. Not only is there a very huge gap, almost 20% in the highly educated women, but if you compare within the non-members, no schooling 56%, 1 to 5 year again 56%, 52% for 6 to 10 years, and then it's falling to 45. So education is actually reducing the chances of minimum dietary diversity. Not much variation across socio-religious groups. OBC 57, 59 for forward caste, 61 for Muslims. In all cases, we find that Jivika members are more likely to ensure minimum dietary diversity. In case of asset holdings, again, we find that there's a positive relation between asset holding and probability of ensuring minimum dietary diversity. So, in case of affluent families, we find a higher incidence of children complying with minimum dietary diversity. So we ran a probit model to test for whether there was any difference between Jivika and non-Jivika members. And in the first case, you can see in case of breastfeeding, there is no difference. The difference is statistically insignificant, even at 10% level. So we can say that the probability of breastfeeding is same across Jivika and non-members after we control for factors like children's birth order of children, years of education, their social religious identity, asset score, and so on. In case of minimum dietary diversity, however, we see that the coefficient is positive, which means that Jivika mothers are more likely to ensure minimum dietary diversity for the children. At the same time, it is highly significant at 1% level. So that means after controlling for the variables, Jivika members, the Jivika program appears to be successful in ensuring minimum dietary diversity. Now let's come to the outcome for mothers. So in this case, we have looked at two outcomes, the dietary score and minimum dietary diversity. So you can see that the dietary score is quite satisfactory, 5.6. The percentage of women who have complied with MDD is also very high, over 90%, which is excellent. However, there's not much difference between Jivika and non-Jivika members. The univariate t-tests indicate that the difference is statistically insignificant, even at 10% level. So now we look at the variation across education levels. The left-hand side is the diversity score, how many food groups are being consumed, and this is the proportion of women who have attained dietary diversity. The important thing is, the interesting thing is that if you look at the low-income, less educated households, Jivika members have a lower dietary score. This light green is the non-members. So this is much higher, comparatively higher than the Jivika scores. After we cross primary level, that is at higher levels of income, we find that the Jivika members have a higher dietary score than the non-members. So in this case, in case of mothers, education is acting as a positive driver. If the woman is more educated, she is likely to ensure to have a high dietary score. And as you can see over here, she is also likely to ensure that she is complying with minimum dietary diversity. Variations across asset class. Again, we find the same variation. At low levels, Jivika members have a lower dietary score. But once they have, if you consider the high income households, then Jivika members, once we consider the high income households, we will find that the Jivika members have a higher dietary score. And in case of minimum dietary diversity, there's not much difference, just 1% difference. But still, we can see that the relation is not perverse. I mean, educated women are more likely to comply with minimum dietary diversity. Household size can also have an impact on dietary score and minimum dietary diversity. A larger household can mean two things. Firstly, there's greater competition for a food basket. Secondly, you have more working members so that the food basket is larger. In case of Jivika members, the deep green line, we can see that in larger households, the dietary score is decreasing. In case of the non-members, the dietary score is increasing sharply. If you look at MDD, minimum dietary diversity, there's not much difference across households and between Jivika and non-Jivika members. Variations across social religious groups, we find that the Muslim community has a higher, substantially higher dietary score compared to other groups. In case of compliance with minimum dietary diversity, we find that Muslim Jivika members are less likely to comply with the minimum dietary diversity. So this is an analysis of the consumption of food groups, and you can see again that the consumption of yellow and orange fruits is very low. Non-veg items is also low, but it's much higher than that of children. Now, we had seen that Muslims have a higher, better dietary score. One reason is that Muslims are generally non-vegetarian, and so they are more likely to consume fish and meat or eggs. So this can explain why, despite being a relatively socio-economically backward community, they have a better dietary score. So this is the results of the econometric analysis. We have run the Probit model for dietary diversity and an ordinary regression model for dietary scores. And we find that the dietary diversity of mothers is higher among Jivika members, and it is statistically significant at 1% level. So this is something which is satisfactory. In case of the dietary score, there's no difference between Jivika and non-Jivika members. So let's sum up and go to the policy implications. Overall, the findings of the study are quite encouraging. Jivika members, the mothers, adhere to recommended dietary practices for themselves. Their dietary score is also high. Minimum dietary diversity is satisfactory among children, but there is scope for improvement. The levels are about 60%. It's possible to increase it to higher levels. Some signposts which the Jivika officers may consider. In case of the child dietary outcomes, consumption of non-vegetarian items is very low, but as I have remarked previously, that it will be very difficult for Jivika to combat this problem. They will have to fight against age-old prejudices and dietary practices. But the area where there can be improvement is in the case of orange and yellow fruits, and in the case of dark green leafy vegetables. Next, the other point that we should note is that education and income is generally believed to be a driver behind the MCH outcomes. In case of exclusive breastfeeding, however, we find that this doesn't hold. The prevalence is lower among educated women and affluent households. Yes.
In this context also, I'd like to point out one thing. During our survey, we found that outreach of ashas among affluent and educated women is limited. They are, you know, going more to the lower educated and the lower affluent households. So the FGDs reveal that ashas visit these homes, actually the houses of affluent and highly educated homes, only to complete forms. So ashas are able to motivate less educated and poorer mothers in context of breastfeeding and other MCH related activities. Jivika has outreach to these educated and affluent families. So Jivika should look at this point well. So if Jivika can improve the exclusive breastfeeding among the educated as well as affluent mothers.
In the case of maternal nutrition, the univariate tests indicated that there was no difference between Jivika and non-Jivika members. The econometric results, however, indicate that once we control for individual and household characteristics, the Jivika mothers are more likely to comply with MDD norms. Here, education seems to be playing a positive role, so Jivika can focus on increasing in awareness, particularly among the more educated variety, among the less educated people, where the compliance with MDD is lower. Now, another fact which we have not discussed in the earlier results is, which comes out in the main findings, is there seems to be a spillover effect from health and nutrition strategy. This is one factor which is reducing the gap between Jivika and non-Jivika members. During focus group discussions, some of the non-members reported that they had been invited to the Jivika meetings, so they were aware of the health and nutrition strategy. They also reported that during informal interaction with their neighbors who were Jivika members, they learned about the benefits of complying with dietary norms. So what is happening is that the Jivika may be targeting its members, but there is a spillover from these members to the non-members. And this may be reducing the gap between the members and non-members. So actually the success of the health and nutrition strategy is cannot be captured if we just look at the difference between members and non-members. Both of them are getting the benefit of health and nutrition strategy. But some warning bells, particularly regarding the monthly meetings of Jivika, non-attendance is a major issue. The young members are respondents. When we discussed how many, raised the issue, how many meetings you have been attending, 50% said that we have not attended any meetings in the last 6 months. They have mobility restrictions, they have to undertake household tasks, they have to look after the children. As a result of these, they are unable to go and attend the meetings personally. In this situation, what they do is they request the mother-in-law, and in some cases the husband also. These people goes and deposits the money, the weekly subscriptions, with the Jivika officers. Regarding the meetings, when the respondents cannot attend the meetings, the mother-in-law often goes and attends the meeting for them. Now, this has a very interesting implication. The SAS becomes the gatekeeper. So we have, on the one hand, the community mobilizer, the CMPD, who is passing on information. The target recipient is the Bahu, but it is a SAS who is standing in between as the gatekeeper and controlling the flow of information to the Bahu. Now, who is the SAS? I mean, we should remember one thing, that in case of urban areas, the SAS and Bahu, there's a huge age gap. In case of Bihar, marriage is very early. The reproductive period generally finishes within 22, 23. And by the age of 40, the woman becomes a grandmother. So the SAS is not a very, very old woman. And in that case, the generation gap between SAS and Bahu may not be very large. There are instances where the SAS has played a very positive role. She has relayed the information. She has accompanied the Bahu to various immunization programs and so on. But we also have many cases where the SAS has created obstacles. She has tried to control to distort or simply withhold information to the Bahu. She has an age-old perception about nutrition dietary norms, and in such cases, she blocks the information flow from the CMDD, and she tries to pass on her own beliefs to the Bahu. So this flow of information, which was revealed in the network maps and focus group discussions, has to be taken care of by Jivika. So thank you, and we wait for any questions and comments. I'll keep this slide share presentation on so that I can refer to any slide.
Thank you. Thank you so much, sir. So certainly the findings are very encouraging. Also a few eye-opener, many things we need to look after also to improve many areas also. So, but this is the good findings and good study reports for us also. So we missed to include the many other World Bank and other other agencies to participate in this presentation. So just I'm now missing it. So however, my teams have my team will also now give you the feedback or queries related to this presentation. So now open for the queries from my team also, please.
Good morning, everybody. Myself, Soumya, project manager.
Soumya ji, aapka voice cut raha hai.
The criteria for selecting districts and block.
Sorry, what was your question? Criteria?
Soumya ji, aapka voice cut raha hai.
Criteria for selecting districts and blocks.
How we selected the blocks?
Districts and blocks, both. Please ask me both.
Okay. So, as I've said, that we identified 13 districts where the JTSP and HNS had been operation for the last 5 years. So, this is the.
How you got selected six districts and from how six,
yeah, yeah, I'm
six
saying.
Districts? Four blocks and then five villages. So what was the basic criteria for selecting these?
Yeah, I'm explaining that. Okay, so out of the 38 districts in Bihar, we looked at, yeah, we identified the districts where JTSP and HNS had been in operation for 5 years.
Okay,
so these are the 13 districts.
Okay.
Then we created an index using three figures: female literacy, forward caste population, and male non-agricultural workforce.
From 2011 census.
Okay.
So creating, applying equal weightage, we created this index. Okay. Then we divided these 13 districts into three groups. So this is low, this is medium, and high. Using random numbers, we selected two districts from each of the groups. So Saharsa Nalanda, low index, Purva Champaran, Katihar, high index.
Okay.
After that, let us say we took Saharsa. In Saharsa, we divided the blocks into two groups. A group is where HNS was in operation. We randomly selected two blocks. B group is where HNS was not in operation for 5 years. So we selected
But sir, in Saharsa, all 10 blocks were in receiving HNS information since last 5 years. And in some blocks where Parivartan was not working, we were doing a different World Bank study. So Saharsa, all blocks were receiving FNS information, SSGs were receiving.
We got the list from Jivika actually. The block division was based on Jivika.
The list which was shared by the Jivika, from that only we have selected. We have not done anything from ourselves.
Yeah, I got that.
Achha. After that, within a block, we generated random numbers and selected five villages. So the random number was generated using the PPS method. And within the village, we selected 20 respondents. See, the normal way is to use household listing, but household listing could not be employed because some of the, in fact, when we went to Vaishali, a large number of Jivika members was reluctant to reveal that they were members. So, in that case,
Particularly in front of husband and other elder male family members.
So, in that case, we decided to abandon household listing and we simply asked that how many Jivika members who were present at that time in the village and had a child of less than 36 months.
Yes, please.
In Vaishali, women were reluctant to accept the fact that they are SAG members.
Yeah, they were saying that. See, in one case, what happened was, when we went to her, she said, "I'm not a member." Hmm. So we put her in the non-member category and interviewed her. Then one of the neighbors told us that she's actually a member. So we waited, but her husband doesn't know. So we waited. When the husband went away, we went back and asked her, and she said, "Yes, I'm a member, but my husband was there, so I didn't want to reveal in front of him." And we found that this problem occurred several times in the invitation.
और भी टीम मेंबर पूछ सकते हैं विनोद जी मनोज
Any query question from the IGC team also, if there any?
I have a question regarding this dietary score. Can we go to that slide?
Yes, just one. Yes.
Score. Go to score.
Acha, the results.
Yes.
Okay. Yes.
Yeah. The scores.
So there I had seen dietary score that was 5.64%.
Yes.
For Jivika members.
Yes.
So no, it is not percent actually.
It's the average.
It's the average. Means
it's average among the food groups. Is it the average among the food groups which we have enlisted in last slide?
Right. There are eight food groups in which the mean is 6.65. The average is of 6.65.
5.6.
Yeah, sorry. I mean 5.65.
So this was food groups for child or that mother?
No, mother. This is for mother.
This for mother.
From here, I'm starting from mothers.
Okay. And what about that child wala?
Child actually we didn't
have dietary diversity.
उसमें हम लोग सीधा डायरेक्टली डाइवर्सिटी में चले गए हैं और एक्सक्लूसिव डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन में चले गए, बट वन कैन कैलकुलेट इट इजीली.
या इट्स अ मच लोअर 3.6.
सो दैट मींस डायटरी स्कोर वाज क्वाइट गुड, वी कैन से लाइक आउट ऑफ 5
आउट ऑफ 8
मेंबर्स आर टेकिंग आउट ऑफ 8. ओके, आउट ऑफ 8 5 एट लीस्ट 5 दे आर टेकिंग
मोर देन 5 एक्चुअली 5.6.
Can you share the list of the food groups that you have presented in the slide?
Yes.
So this is food groups for mother or the children?
For both.
For both.
For children, so it is above 6 months.
Above 6 months. So basically, in our messagings, we promote 10 food groups, and the pulses we calculate in the separate food groups, and cereal are different food groups. One thing in this, the observations from outside. So this is based on the World Bank's categorizations of 10 food groups.
Yes. Yes.
So, can you have the segregations of cereals and pulses differently, if possible, in the findings part? If possible, what the results will be? If that will be in the category.
Oh, sorry, there's a typo over here. It should be cereals and potatoes.
Cereals and potatoes and then nuts and pulses. Yeah, then fish and meat. Then eggs, then milk, and other types
of products. Yeah. So we generally count the 10 food groups. So out of the 10 food groups, the other fruits and vegetables are we consider in the two different groups.
Okay, so it's like this. 9.
So if you know who are
all it? Nuts and pulses are also different.
Pulses are different and nuts are also different. So pulses will come. This is now.
No, but yes, the NFHS yes. categorization is like this. I mean, NFHS जैसे category बनाते हैं, तो उसमें ये nuts and pulses एक ही शब्द है.
So, in case of the children food groups, we merge the nuts and pulses in one group.
Mm-hmm.
In case of out of 10, that has been merged into the 7 food groups for the children. So how that merging and the compositions is there? Cereal and potatoes are one. Nuts and pulses will come in the one group. Then it reduce one group more. Similarly, the other vegetable and other fruits comes in one group. In case of the child food groups, we count 7. Similarly, the dark green leafy vegetables and dark green leafy vegetables and yellow fruits. This comes into one group for the children.
7 and 8.
7 and 8.
No, we have followed the criteria used by.
One observation from our understanding. So, based on the different extended food groups that we follow. So, if you may check either it is typo error or that has been done accordingly. So, 7 food groups and 10 food groups are similar. That one observation from our side. So, next one after this. But the slide, next slide. So now you got the 7 food groups, na? And 10 food groups and 7 food groups is now clear, na? As per
yes,
our...
Yes, yes, eight food. Yes.
So...
We can combine food groups, but we cannot desegregate them.
Right.
So this is the child. So we generally take the groups 6 to 23. So you may also take the 6 to 35. So basically, in case of the pregnant mother, what we generally found, initially mother are taking care of their children's and mother also take the dietary diversity initial stage only, after one and six year only. After that, the ratio or average of the consumption that reduces. So if we'll take the more number of period of lactating mother's consumptions, maybe that will also affect the findings may be different. So from our side, that may be our observations, or you may also calculate based on your presentation. Secondly, see the mother minimum dietary diversity consumptions week basically here promote out of 10, 5 food groups. As per the WHO or the standard food organizations. So that you can also check. See, out of 10, 5 food groups for maternal, and out of 7, 4 out of 7 for children.
चिल्ड्रन के लिए तो ठीक है, हम लोग कर कर सकते हैं, लेकिन मदर के लिए कर नहीं सकते, क्योंकि हम लोग डेटा ही कलेक्ट किया है ऐसे करके आठ ग्रुप में.
ओके ओके देन सो सो हाँ सो सेकेंडली वी हैव आल्सो नाउ इन 20th दिसंबर एनएपीएचएस डेटा हैज आल्सो कम आउट. So yes. In Bihar, in the stunting rates, solid initiation of solid liquid, few things are already showing the good results for Bihar compared to the other highly density based states like Maharashtra, West Bengal, Bihar, Andhra Pradesh, and other. Compared to those districts, Bihar has good results. So you can also take reference if something is relevant for you and for the analysis part or for your any reference, you can also take from them also. So for the validations also, for your any understanding. Next, please. next one, already you have told this one.
This sample size
is no problem for our side. So here, yeah. The number,
yes,
this table, this one. So total number of non-Jivika and Jivika is both are different and same number, na?
Yes, only two. Two difference.
One is 112, and other is 112.
Okay. So, and the economic category and caste category are also similar, or that maybe numbers will be vary?
Caste category is almost
similar. Caste is almost same. 2% difference is not much. Occupation is also more or less same.
And economic status, that income and other thing, and
yeah, that is also same. Just 1-2%.
Okay. The next one,
only difference is education.
Okay. So in one slide, as you told, we also believe that education directly not relations that has no relationship with the improvement of the health outcomes. So in this case also, many places showing that highly educated are also not practicing. So again, please repeat. So what do you mean, or what your understanding or analysis of this report, where the educations are improving in the SAGs, but practicing part, adoptions of data diversity is not improving. So what your analysis on that?
Okay.
So sir, are you getting
about,
my question?
About this? You're talking about this, this point.
Yes, yes, I think so. Yes, yes.
हाँ
मतलब
उनका जो कहना है कि मतलब education का जो positive externality है, that is not coming out.
यही ना? It is. It is not coming out for breastfeeding, and one reason may be that the women think that for some reason, see, it's not just education also; it's also the high income.
Yes. So,
I mean, possibly one factor is educated women are also high income, and they are able to substitute items, artificial items.
So many studies also कि many studies says कि जहाँ पर भी अगर income की बात है या education की बात है that has not direct relationship with the improvement of the health outcomes also. That's why in Jivika major focus of the project is to enhance livelihood. However, we are focusing to promote income or livelihood, but also required separate interventions. That why we are also promoting health nutrition, so that separate effort will contribute towards the growth that is going on for in livelihood enhancement or income enhancement. That will contribute for the longer sustainability of the livelihood also. Well, based on that concept that we are also promoting, and that is also your pending also saying similar pending. So that is for us. So हम लोग के understanding के आधार पर की जो understanding या अलग से effort की आवश्यकता है, that जहाँ जहाँ हम लोग effort कर रहे हैं, then that changing is visible. और जहाँ पर उसको अलग से एफर्ट की आवश्यकता है इवन दे हैव द गुड इनकम हैव द गुड एजुकेशन
यस इनफैक्ट वी लुक्ड एट सम अदर इंडिकेटर्स आल्सो एंड कंपेयर्ड बिटवीन जीविका एंड नॉन मेंबर्स सो दीस आर एरियाज वेयर विच जीविका वाज नॉट कवरिंग एंड प्रेडिक्टिवली वी फाउंड दैट देयर वाज नो डिफरेंस बिटवीन जीविका एंड नॉन मेंबर्स
For which?
Like contraception use,
okay.
And ANC services.
Yes, yes.
So this is
that part. So, also, we are not promoting regular.
Yes.
So if so major. Please.
So if it is because of the sample profile, if our results are because of sample profile, we would have a difference for those also.
On those areas, basically, we are not promoting, it's not focusing
exactly.
Interventions equally, like the dietary diversity part we are focusing.
Yes.
So that dietary diversity, why we have taken that, I have one reasons for us also that I am sharing here. The entire 1000 days window, first life 1000 life window generally after conceives pregnant women to the 2 years of the child. That completely we consider it the 1000 days window of the first life, first 1000 days of life. इस period में generally जितने stunting हुए हैं जो physical और mental growth होता है इसी period में होता है ये देखा गया है कि कंप्लीमेंट्री फीडिंग आफ्टर 6 मंथ नहीं होने से स्टंटिंग हुआ है और स्टंटिंग हो 2 साल के बाद उस पे कोई हम रिकवरी कोई दूसरा इंटरवेंशन सक्सेसफुल नहीं होता है
नहीं
और कंप्लीमेंट्री फीडिंग होना ये 50% कंट्रीब्यूट करता है स्टंटिंग के लिए इसीलिए हमने डाइटी डाइवर्सिटी प्रमोट कर रहे हैं पैटर्न के लिए और जो चाइल्ड है उसको 6 मंथ से स्टार्ट करने का तो कहीं ना कहीं जो 50% कंट्रीब्यूटर्स है स्टंटिंग के लिए वो कंप्लीमेंट्री फीडिंग 6 मंथ में नहीं स्टार्ट करना सो हम लोग अगर स्टंटिंग को रिड्यूस करेंगे, एक लॉन्ग टर्म इम्पैक्ट है इसका, और ये थ्री जनरेशन होता है, तो हम लोग इसलिए इसमें डाइटी डाइवर्सिटी पे काफी एफर्ट की है। तो जो स्टंटिंग वाला है बिहार में, जो NFHS डेटा में भी 5 पॉइंट का रिडक्शन आया है, ये बड़ा नंबर है कंपेयर टू दी
42 हो गया है, 48 से 42 हो गया।
So maybe that interventions may have contributed somewhere.
Right. और उससे भी जो important एक बात है कि आपका इसका जो spillover effect है, मतलब वो जो non-immigrant है, उन लोग के पास भी information इसके ही बारे में जा रहा है। तो ये भी एक important चीज है ना, जो आपका इसका जो spillover effect।
So other areas are also required, but still because we need some focus interventions and also need to institutionalize the interventions through our CBOC institutions, community institutions. That's why we selected interventions we are implementing. Certainly we'll also scale up with the newer, more other interventions like family planning and other things also. So, exclusive breastfeeding part is still from our side, little bit we need to check how it is happening. Maybe the age category you have expanded up to 36 months, maybe that reasons or any...
breastfeeding 0 to 5 months.
Oh, 0 to... Yeah, okay. Good. Huh. But in this data, NPHS data that's showing... they have not segregated actually, Anna, SG and SG. You have segregated here. So right. It may be, we may accept. Kya Soumya? Exclusive breastfeeding mein, Bihar mein improvement hua hai. So, lekin yahan hum log SG and SG ko separate kar rahe hain, usme contributions hum log ka average hi hai. So, why it is still... to understand for me. Exclusive breastfeeding का campaigns काफी हुए हैं, हम लोग इसको बहुत ज्यादा promote किए हैं, compared to the dietary diversity, it is not. Dietary diversity बहुत ज्यादा हुआ है, पर exclusive breastfeeding भी काफी हुए हैं, लेकिन इस ख्याल पे
वो तो है, लेकिन बात यह है कि आपका exclusive breastfeeding तो एक age old practice है ना, कि आपके yes. पास आपका आपका घर में दूध है, भैंस है, आपका गाय है, ये है, तो इसके लिए एक जो सास ने जो बोलेगा कि नहीं दूध इसको खिलाओ बाहर का, तो फिर दूध खिलाएगा मतलब सास के पास तो इन्फॉर्मेशन है ना क्या क्या करना है।
सो बेसिकली हम लोग जब प्रमोट कर रहे हैं, मोबिलाइज कर रहे हैं, उसमें सिग्निफिकेंट अगर चेंजेस या डिफरेंसेस नहीं दिख रहा है, दैट इज अलार्मिंग फॉर आवर अंडरस्टैंडिंग।
इसके लिए हम लोग जो बात बोल रहे हैं कि आपका सास को थोड़ा टारगेट करना चाहिए,
दैट इज सर्टेनली दैट इज द पॉजिटिव फीडबैक और पॉजिटिव फाइंडिंग्स आल्सो, बट वी आर आल्सो कंडक्टिंग द डेमोंस्ट्रेशन कैंपेन।
सर होम इज द मोस्ट इम्पोर्टेंट टूल, इस स्टडी से यही ये चीज सामने निकल के आ रही है कि डिस्कशन एसएचजी में अगर होता भी है तो वो इंफॉर्मेशन का फ्लो कहीं ना कहीं उसमें हिंड्रेंस है। तो जो होम विजिट होती है जिसमें कि फैमिली मेंबर्स और बेनिफिशियरी दोनों होते हैं, तो वहाँ पे टारगेट हम लोग को और ज्यादा इफेक्टिवली करना पड़ेगा। लास्ट में एक बात आपने और लिखी थी कि स्पिल ओवर इफेक्ट्स में फोकस ग्रुप डिस्कशन करता, तो जब भी हम कोई कैंपेन करते हैं या और भी एक्टिविटीज होती हैं, तो ऐसा नहीं है कि सिर्फ और सिर्फ जीविका एसएचजी मेंबर्स तक ही जानकारी जाती है, नॉन मेंबर्स के बीच भी जानकारी जाती है। तो ये भी एक रीजन हो कि जीविका और नॉन जीविका में सिग्निफिकेंट डिफरेंस नहीं दिख रहा है, बट इट्स हम लोग के लिए ये इंट्रोस्पेक्शन का की बात है कि इतना एफर्ट करने के बाद भी अगर सिग्निफिकेंट डिफरेंस नहीं दिख रहा है, तो वी नीड टू चेंज आवर स्ट्रेटजी और रीलुक ऑन दैट।
सो वन फैक्टर टू फैक्टर्स नाउ वी आर आइडेंटिफाइंग हियर, वन थिंग इज मदर इन लॉ, सेकंड इज रिप्ले जो अभी क्या
रिपल इफेक्ट सर, वो जो समुदाय में होती है, सर
जो हाई स्किल ओवरसीज है ना वो ज्यादा हो रहा है दैट इज आल्सो मे बी वी लुक राइट ओके
देखिए स्पिल ओवर इफेक्ट अगर होगा जस्ट वन से इफ देयर इज अ स्पिल ओवर इफेक्ट अगर होगा तो ये प्रोग्राम और भी सक्सेसफुल बनाएंगे लेकिन वो सक्सेस फिगर से दिखा नहीं जाएगा हम लोग जब इवैल्यूएशन करेंगे लगेगा जे जीविका नॉन जीविका तो सेम ही है लेकिन स्पिल ओवर का मतलब है दोनों ही बेनिफिट हो रहा
है ये एक्सेप्टिंग
हां एक्चुअली इट इंडिकेट द सक्सेस ऑफ जीविका
बट वी शुड
लीव टोटल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन अगर आप कहें सर तो ये बात सही है कि हमने पूरी सोसाइटी में इस पे काम किया बट कहीं ना कहीं हमें अपना इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर की आवश्यकता तो है ही कि उतना सिग्निफिकेंट डिफरेंस क्यों नहीं दिख रहा है गुड कि और लोग भी इससे लाभ हां बट दोनों घर से जुड़े हुए ऑब्वियस उनको और ज्यादा इसको प्रैक्टिसेस करनी चाहिए थी तो वी नीड टू लुक टू रिलुक ऑन दिस पॉइंट
बेसिकली हम लोग ये अंजम्सन है कि ऑलमोस्ट ऑल पुअर आर इन एसएजी फॉल्ड सो जो नन मेंबर हैं स्टिल वी आर हु आर दी आज यू आर टेलिंग कि सिमिलर इकोनॉमिक क्लास के हैं तो स्टिल सम पुअर हाउसहोल्ड आर लेफ्ट आउट एंड दे इफ दे आर लेफ्ट आउट स्टिल एंड दे आर आल्सो हैव द मोर स्पिल ओवर इफेक्ट्स सो वी आल्सो amazing feedback for me, for us also. एक तो है कि हम लोग 1 crore 20 lakh households जुड़े हुए हैं and among them many of the pregnant lactating वाला जो है वो 40-45% के आसपास है 47% के आसपास ये जो reproductive period के या के लोग हैं जो target group हमारे तो maximum लोग हमारे पास हैं और नन एसएजी हैं वो भी अगर पुअर हैं तो एसएजी फोल्ड में आने चाहिए अगर सिमिलर हैं तो अगर थोड़ा इलीट हैं थोड़ा वेल ऑफ हैं तो मे बी दे अडॉप्शन एंड अदर थिंग्स दे क्विकली टेक अप एंड स्पिल ओवर इफेक्ट को जस्टिफाई कर सकते हैं ओके नेक्स्ट वन
ओके
एक का कंजम्पशन बिहार में काफी ज्यादा है मुस्लिम के अलावे भी सो इन दिस रिपोर्ट वी आर नॉट शोइंग इन केस ऑफ द कास्ट बेस आप एनालिसिस कर रहे हैं उसमें जो फूड का कंजम्पशन दिखा रहे थे फूड ग्रुप्स का कंजम्पशन
मदर्स तो वो चाहे तो कंजम्पशन
मदर के लिए अच्छा है लेकिन आपका चाइल्ड के लिए बहुत खराब है बच्चे के लिए
बहुत कम है
मदर के लिए अच्छा है मदर के लिए जब मदर के लिए आपका 40-50% लेकिन ये जो आपका चाइल्ड में आपका बहुत कम आ रहा है चाइल्ड
का बहुत कम
सर्टेनली वी नीड टू फोकस दिस इशू ऑन दिस फूड ग्रुप्स
और वेजिटेबल्स ऑरेंजेस ये भी कम है चाइल्ड के लिए
Yes. That study is shown in the NFHS4 also in the earlier studies also showing. Even the World Bank IFRI study also.
Mother के लिए ये orange fruit कम. और fish and meat eggs relatively कम. Vitamin A deficiency. Fish में ठीक ही है और बढ़ सकता है लेकिन
सर आई हैव अ क्वेश्चन
यस
इसमें क्या सर्वे में आपने क्या पूछा था लास्ट डे का उनका क्या कंजम्पशन था वो पूछा था या क्या क्योंकि यहाँ पे फिश और मीट का परसेंटेज भी बहुत अच्छा दिख रहा है देखा जाए 60% ये किस कैसे लिया गया था डेटा लास्ट डे का या
किस तरह का लिया जाता है, इसलिए सर ये आपका अच्छा दिख रहा है। अदरवाइज
एक मिनट बच्चे के लिए हम लोग लिए थे लास्ट 24 आवर्स रिकॉल पीरियड, ठीक है, बच्चे के लिए।
और मदर्स में,
मदर्स के लिए मदर्स के लिए वीकली लिए थे और बच्चे के लिए लास्ट 24 आवर्स लिए थे।
सर मेरे हम लोग इसलिए बोल रहे हैं कि आपको यदि वुमेन में भी 24 आवर्स का यदि आपने लिया होता तो आपका परसेंटेज इतना बढ़िया नहीं रहता। लेकिन व्हाट इज द रीजन फॉर टेकिंग 24 वन वीक डेटा एंड फॉर चिल्ड्रन 124 आवर्स, व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस?
ये भी आपका एनएफएचएस का अगर आप ये देखेंगे, क्वेश्चन देखेंगे, उसमें भी ऐसा ही है।
ओके, क्योंकि हम लोग करेक्ट वे, बिकॉज वी आर ऑल्सो अंडरटेकिंग अ सिमिलर स्टडी जिसमें हम रिकॉल मेथड पे केवल 24 आवर का ही ऑब्जर्वेशन लेते हैं, जिसके कारण हमारा वहाँ यदि
मेरा जो ख्याल है उसमें आपका मदर और एडल्ट के लिए 24 आवर्स रिकॉल के रूप में अच्छा इतना अच्छा रिजल्ट आपको देगा नहीं है, क्योंकि उसमें फास्टिंग की बात होगा, उसमें आपका मतलब घर में अगर कोई अगर गेस्ट भी आएगा उसका भी यो जाएगा, बात हो जाएगा। तो इसके लिए एडल्ट के लिए हम लोग हमेशा ही मतलब वीकली रिपोर्टिंग या ये करते प्रेफर करते हैं।
ओके सर,
बच्चे के लिए बच्चे के लिए 24 आवर्स इज फाइन, बट नॉट फॉर द एडल्ट। एडल्ट के लिए आपको वीकली डेटा लेना ही रिलायबल है ज्यादा।
सर कैन यू जस्ट शेयर अस सम डॉक्यूमेंट्स रिलेटेड टू दिस, सो बिकॉज़ वी आर फॉलोइंग अ सिमिलर मतलब वी आर डूइंग अ सिमिलर स्टडी बट टेकिंग अ डिफरेंट मेजर मेजरमेंट वे। हां
ओके
ओके ठीक ओके
That,
sir, you can send it to Purti sir, we'll take it from him.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, so any other query, question?